Oh, you heard this very beautiful song of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Hari Nam Hua Anika Swarup. Originally, he had translated the shloka of Srila Rupa Goswami. And after that, his heart will be very pure. After that, in Sadhu Sangha, he will practice bhajan. And after that, nishtha may come. And after that, if it is matured, nishtha, then will come the bhajan. But you should know, this is the difference between Raganuga and Vaidhi. Vaidhi, you will have to begin from Shraddha, then Sadhu Sangha, Anartha Nivritti, and all other things. But in Raganuga Bhakti, it begins from Ruchi. It begins. At one, from Ruchi. He will take initiation from a bona fide Guru, Rasika, and Bhava. And by the impression of past lives and also new in this present birth, he will have a greed in bhajan, not in bhajaniya, in the limbs of bhakti, sarvanam, kirtanam, smaranam, padasevan, 9. And after 9, 5, sadhu sanganam, kirtan, bhagavat, sraman, mathura, bhashi, vritti, saddhaya, sima. And among them, shravanam, kirtanam, smaranam. And among them, tar madhya sarvashrestha naam sankirtanam. Because it includes all 64 limbs of all bhakti. And in that 64, you know something about bhavamayi sadhan, bhava-sambandhi sadhan. Favorable to bhav, that is sadhan. And then unfavorable, these are all we will have to know. Which are not favorable, yes or give up very strongly. Otherwise bhakti cannot, creeper cannot go up. What is bhavamayi? We have just explained everything, everywhere. Bhavamayi is in 64 limbs of bhakti. Which is bhavamayi? What? Bhav means transcendental bhav, rati in transcendental associate of Krishna in Braja. Understand? The mood of Bhagavad, the moods of Nanda Baba Yashoda Maiya, the moods of Gopis, the moods of Manjaris. These are bhav. Bhav Mai. Those who have some greed to serve Radha Krishna conjugal in the way of Subal Sridham, or this is what? Sakharas. The modes of Nanda Yashoda, Vatsalya, the modes of Gopi, Parkiya mode. Madhur Rasa. In Madhur Rasa, so many divisions, so many parts. Among them, for us, only to follow Rupa Manjari, Rupa Goswami, this is the highest for us. Those see Rupa Manjari is submitted to Lalita Vishakha. So these are bhav, and those who have this bhava in his transcendental constitution, they are called bhavmayi. And those who want to follow, they are bhavanuga, that is raganuga. So bhavmayi and raganuga are not same. Bhavanu, not same. Bhavanuga is sadhak. Or bhavmayi or bhavmayi, what? Transcendental associates of Krishna. So if anyone has some grief to serve Radha Krishna conjugal, like Sukal Sri Ram Padamangal, like Nanda Yashoda, like Gopis, they should follow them. So these are bhavmayi and what bhav? Sambandhi. Related to this, the kirtan, the literature, the anga, by which that limbs will be bhavmaya. What are they? Shravanam, kirtanam, smaranam, adhisevanam, like this. But these parts are also of two kinds. Raganuga, favorable to Raganuga and favorable to Vaidhi Bhakti. In Shravan Kirtan, in Vaidhi Bhakti, you can follow Prahlad Maharaj. Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu Smaranam, Padasevanam, Archanam, Das, Sakhyatmani. This is Vaidhi Bhakti. And now Raganuga Shravanam is some words. Oh, superior. What Shravanam? Well, you should hear Ujjwal Nilmani. First times of sweet Krishna. How Mother Yashoda, with love and affection, binded the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Supreme Power. And he was weeping. Yashoda Mai, taking a stick in his hand. Oh, you restless? Naughty boy. And he is hearing Krishna and weeping. Not what?
Acting.
No, natural. And so Kunti Mata is saying like this. I become in confusion. How it became? That even Krishna, you, and you are fearing of Mother Yashoda. And Gopis what? Oh, you should just stand up, you should sit down. And Krishna, you to do? Gopis, order him, or bring some color and paint all folks' face. And when Krishna did it, and they gave their chap that now you are mine. You are registered document to I. What is this? Oh, this is bhav. Bhav Mahishana. So we should try to know. Though you are not qualified, I know myself too. But I am telling you, this is our aim and object of our life. So, but you will have to practice from Shabda. From Vaidhi Bhakti, I know we have no such thing. If blood will come, oh, then Ruchi is there. So, this period, from Shabda to Ruchi, between, very critical, very critical. Because Sadhak has left his family, his wealth, reputation, and trying to give up his pratishtha. I told about name and fame. Very, very rare, very hard. To give up wealth, reputation, wife, and also body to give up. Very, very easy. But give him pratishtha. Oh, very rare, very hard. And at that time, Sadaka has no taste. No taste. But he has left all. And he is waiting what? Not on earth, not on heaven, or in midst, like Trishanku at that time. He cannot control. If Ruchi, for him, Ruchi is like earth, place to stand up. And if now Ruchi, and you have left everything, then you may fall down. If there is no high class of association. And if you are so weak, no harm, full of unearth even, but you are taking shelter of any high class of associates like Guru, Vaishnava, Rashi, Bahu, Tattvya, then, oh, no fear. And when you will come to Ruchi, then very rare cases to fall down. So up to Ruchi, you should be very careful. I know thousands of devotees, they left everything, but no Ruchi and no association. Even Nishtha was there. So you should wait till Ruchi comes. I know no taste in the Harikatha. Hearing Harikatha and getting by this year. So we should try for Ruchi. How it will come? After Nishtha, in high class of association, hearing pastimes of Krishna. Hearing mostly the lives of Srila Rupa Goswami, Raghunath Das Goswami, Krishna Das Padiraj, Jiva Goswami, Narottam Thakur, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, Indirain, Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Srila Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhartha Saraswati and others. It will help. So, now I am coming in the Ruchi. Na dhanam, na janam, na sundarim kavita vajavadishakam. Mama janmani janmani shvari bhavatad bhakti varahaituti. What is the meaning?
Nadanam, Najanam, Nasundarim, Kavitam, Baja, Grisha, Kamae, Mama, Janmani, Janishvari, Bhagavatam, Bhakti, Alaikipai. So, this fourth verse of Shikshasakam by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Now, he is outlining the symptoms of that devotee who is entering into Shuddha Bhakti, saying, Nadanam, that I do not want any wealth. Najanam, I do not want any followers. Nadanam Najanam Nasundarim Kavitam Vajagrisha Kamehe. Nor do I want any, sometimes it's translated, beautiful ladies or poetry. That Nadanam Najanam Nasundarim Kavitam Vajagrisha Kamehe Mama Janmi Janmi Spray. That birth after birth, that I only want your unalloyed devotional service birth after birth.
In Nishtha. He is struggling. He is struggling. Sometimes he may want griha, dravya, shishya and all other things. He can. But when Ruchi will come, the standard of Ruchi is that at that time, all this will come. That at that time, no attachment for worldly things. Na dhanam, na janam, na sundari, kavita, va, jagadish, kamai. Only ahetuki bhakti. What? Ahetuki? Causeless bhakti. That has been told in Srimad Bhagavatam, Rupa Goswami. Savai punsam paro dharmo yato bhaktir. Like this, everywhere. So, in the ruchi, all they become. Not all these are runners. So they become. And only ruchi will be for Krishna bhajan. And in ashakti, it will be mature, this ruchi. And ruchi will be there, and also she will be like ashakti, both. Ruchi in bhakti and bhajan, and ruchi in bhajaniya Krishna. So, this very naturally, this will come. It has been told in Srimad Bhagavatam. Yatha taror moon nishe chayena trityanti tat skanda bhujo vashakha pranu paharacha jathendriyanam tathaiva sarvaharnam achyate jya chamrani.
By serving Achyuta, the infallible Supreme Lord Krishna, all other activities are automatically taken care of, maintenance and all other kinds of happiness. This understanding begins at Shraddha and is condensed and intensified at the stage of Ruchi. If one hand wants to give food to another hand, the other hand won't get nourished. That hand has to feed the stomach, and then the hands, the feet, everything is nourished. If one tries to water each leaf and branch of a tree, then nothing will happen. The whole tree will wither, all the parts. But if one waters the root, then everything is served. Similarly, the whole universe is served in all living entities when Achyuta, the infallible Lord, is served.
Krishna will be served. As all demigods are served by Krishna, Krishna will be served only by what? Ata parahita suraja nahi jani radha grahita madhava nahi mani. Sun cannot be without it. What? It rays and hotness, he may give up, but Madhav cannot be without. In Madhav world, there is Ma, most beloved, that is Radhika is there. So try to know this fact in our Gaudiya Parampara Dhara.
Hare Hare
Players should be ready. In 10 minutes, we will begin. I wanted to finish 4th and 5th, but I mean, tell you, in the feet of first of the Tuttaja, Ruchi, in the beginning, I cannot further advance. So, Bhaktivinoda Thakur has collected. Vishadar has come in Madhyam Ahuja. He can recognize who is the really Vaishnava or not. Some standard he can think. He has some difference between Bhakta and Abhakta. Before this, Kanishtha Adhikari, no duty, nothing to do. Uttam Adhikari, nothing to do, adhikari or not adhikari. They are topmost paramahansa. So only the duty has been divided in madhyam adhikari. Prema, maitri, kripa, upeksha. So when a devotee comes in the stage of nishtha, he is in madhyam adhikari, but Kanishta Madhyam Adhikari. No? It is not Madhyam Madhyam Adhikari or not Madhyam Uttam. Madhyam Kanishta. And when he will come in this stage of Ruchi, then Madhyam Uttam. He is beginning Uttam Bhava. And then he will come to Ashakti. And more than Ashakti, that Rati or then he is Uttam Bhava. Now we can know what is the three pastimes of Krishna. Like Sukadeva Goswami, like Narada Goswami, like others. But in his stage also, in the Rati, he is sadhav, like Dilvamukha, not like Narada. Narada was in his first stage. So, Sukadeva Goswami is called Kasaki, Nirdhut Kasaya. And first stage Narada Rishi, Murchit Kasaya. And second stage of Narada, Prapta Parshad Deha. They are all Uttam. But really Paramahansa Narada is not Sadhar. Until Sukadeva Goswami, there are some unwanted things or washed away, but in Narada, first stage, Murchi, they can again come up. So, even in Rati, anyhow, if Nama Parad will come, Vaishnava Parad, Guru Bhaktya, Shastra, Nindan will come, Dehatma Buddhi may come. very dangerous. Even from then, he can deviate. But when he will be in highest prem, even a slightest part of prem is there. Now, no at all, this one. So, when he will come in Madhyam Adhikari and after Nishtha, beginning of Ruchi, he will be in Madhyam Adhikari. He may know this Siddhanta, he will be Siddhanta Nipun. And all will be attracted by his Siddhanta. If anyone is expert in bhakti, his behavior will be very sweet. His Harikatha will be very sweet. So all audience can be attracted, especially ladies. May come so much because their bhav very dangerous to check themselves, control at that time. So Rupa Goswami has written, Nasishyar Anu Van Badmiyat Granthan Naiva Abhyas. Is bahun na vyakhan upajin jita na rabdya sri kvachit. He has told that so many will come that, oh help me, I want to be initiated by you. So many disciples may come. Thousands and thousands may come. But fall will be, Rupa Goswami is telling. If you are doing so many shishya, disciples, with a law that he is wealthy, if he will come, that all will know me. And thus I will be prominent in whole this world. Oh, thousands and thousands of disciples, very qualified. Don't read so many granths, the scriptures. Only read bhakti. Only, Srimad Bhagavatam. Pita, you can read the books of Rupa Goswami, Jiva Goswami, all the Sonar Chakravarti Thakur, Bhakti Ved, Baladev Vidya Bhushan and all that. You can be expert in this. But other than that, astrology grantha. You know, and so many things. Oh, so many wants to know the mantra of so many things. Don't go to us there. No yoga there. No other thing. No Vasita Devi gods. Only bhakti gram. Don't maintain your life by Shastra Vyakha. Explaining Shiva Bhagavat for 7 days. Oh, so much money will come and then I will nourish and support my family. Don't do. And so many big what? Na arambhe. Oh, big temple. I will make a temple in whole world, highest temple and biggest temple in the world. And whole life is given in that and whole energy and no bhakti. Don't do this. So Bhakti Vinod Thakur. He's telling, quoting all these things. Bahu shishya lobhete ajyogya shishya kare. If you are doing so many disciples, then so many bad, unqualified shishya will come, they will quarrel, and even they will try to cut his Gurudev also. We know so many examples. So many. A disciple, very learned, only qualified, he has post graduation also, very qualified, and Gurudev gave him so many charges to do. But anyhow, there were difference of opinion from a Mahatma Guru, really he was Guru. And one day when something was difference of opinion, he was pickpocketing money from book selling. And then he told that you should not do, be careful. Otherwise your bhakti will be ruined. And then he took some And when he was sleeping in the midnight, he came like that. He wanted to cut. But the guru anyhow, very expert, he changed his direction. He kept his feet towards head and he was sleeping. And it went in the midst of feet. No injury at all. And what began? At once left. Still he is preaching. Oh, you should be faithful to Gurudev. What faithful? He had no belief in Krishna, in Guru, and even me. So if anyone will do this, then we will have to face so many problems. So, Devasi Narad is telling to Maharaj Yudhishthira this thing, that any renounce order, sannyasi, they should be always saranagat to Narayan, because Dhandi is Narayan. Also, for remember Guru gifts, that Dhandi will punish you, Dhanda. So, you should think that he is Narayan, embodiment of Narayan. He should be very humble to all. Hitaishi. He should be hitakari also. Well-wisher of all, without caste and creed. For maintenance of his life, he should not do any business. Adamba means? Don't do anything. Don't look mad, so many big high temples. Your whole life will be disturbed. Do what easy you can do. Very easy you can do. Like Swamiji did, established preaching circle, thousand and thousand. But for him nothing. So the Prabhupada did. But you, oh, only one temple, you'll take your whole life and energy. You should not go. So many things have been written. Now we want to see the drama play. You can see. And tomorrow, again, only one day we are here. So I will come tomorrow also, and then we will go to Spain. And the devotees of Spain are inviting you all. You can come and welcome here. Gaur Premanande.
If Krishna goes to Sundrasha to play, then why doesn't he take Lakshmi with him? What is the harm? Oh Prabhu, please hear the confidential reason for this. Lakshmi Devi cannot be admitted into Vrindavan, even though she performed severe austerities in Vailvan for thousands and thousands of years. Then Krishna came and asked her,
"Oh Lakshmi, what are you doing? You are the goddess of fortune. You possess all opulence. So why are you performing such severe austerities? What could you possibly want?"
"Actually, I want a benediction from you."
"Yes. What would you like?"
"I want to participate in Ras Leela."
"That is absurd. How can you?
Come on. Why not?"
"It's not possible. You should ask for any other benediction."
"I only want this.
use your body to move some spotlights around.
Okay. Then you must take birth from the womb of a gopi in Vrindavan.
Oh, really?
Yes. And you must give up this Brahmini Abhiman, all this opulence. You must milk cows and make cow dung patties.
Make cow dung patties?
Yes. Can you do?
I don't know.
Not only that. You'll have to give up your husband Narayan. Marry a gopa. Cheat on him. And become my beloved. And in this way, you can enter into Parakya Ras.
Give up my chastity to my husband? How can I?
You should follow in the footsteps of the Nityasiddh gopis. Only under their guidance can you enter Rasabina.
I cannot give up my chastity to my husband or marry a gopa under anyone's guidance. This is out of the question. Is there any other way?
There is no other way.
Then what should I do?
Then you must wait until you become qualified.
Baladev and Subhadra with him to Vrindavan on the pretext of seeing the Navaratri festival and recovering his health. But upon arriving in Vrindavan, he leaves his brother and sister behind and enjoys confidential pastimes in these gardens with his beloved gopis. Since there is no fault at all in Krishna's pastimes, then why does Lakshmi become angry with him?
It is the nature of a girl who is completely afflicted by love to become immediately angry upon the slightest neglect from her lover.
Where are you hiding him? What is he doing? Recovering his health? You can't make a fool out of me. You are guilty, and for this you will be punished. Arrest them!
A coup in the three walls can please and satisfy a Prabhu like Lakshmi can.
So why did your lord abandon the great obelisk of the goddess of fortune here in Walker for the sake of a few leaves, fruits and flowers in the garden of Srimati Radharani, Darwin?
Your master is Vidarbha Shivamani, the crown jewel of all Edinburgh. So has he lost his mind?
Lakshmi Devi, I promise to bring her Prabhu back again.
Go on! Please forgive us. We promise we'll bring your Prabhu back by tomorrow.
Yes, you better had, or there'll be trouble.
To exhibit man, she used to remove all their golden ornaments, then enter a dark private room, put on old garments, and then sit down in a sulky mood, scratching the ground with her nails and weeping continually. But here, I see another kind of man in Lakshmi. She is like a commander-in-chief, going to attack the enemy with many soldiers. like it. Please, tell me of all the varieties of man exhibited by the gopis in Vrindavan.
The man of the gopis is like a river flowing with hundreds of tributaries. There is Hetu man with a cause, and Ahetu man without a cause. There are three types of nayakas or heroines, Dira or sober, Adira or restless, and Dira Adira both sober and restless. The sober heroine conceals her anger within her heart and externally speaks sweetly and smiles to her lover. Sometimes she reciprocates with his embraces and sometimes refutes his advances. The restless heroine sometimes speaks harshly to her lover, chastising him, striking him with a lotus, and binding him with a flower garland. The sober, restless gopi always jokes equivocally with her lover, sometimes praises him, sometimes blasphemes him, and sometimes remains indifferent towards him. Oh, please go on. What other types of heroines are there? There is Mukta, captivated, Madhya, or intermediate, and Pragalbha, or impudent. The captivated gopi, upon being cheated by her lover, not knowing much about the intricacies of man, simply hides her face and goes on crying. Then when her lover tries to pacify her, she's immediately satisfied. The intermediate and impudent gopis are sometimes sober, sometimes restless, and sometimes sober and restless. Some of them are very outspoken, some of them are mild, and some are equipoised. Yet all of them are transcendental and faultless, and individually increase Krishna's loving ecstasy with their many different varieties of unique moods. Oh, all these ecstatic moods of the gopis are totally astonishing. Please, tell me more. Some gopis, like Chandravali, are right wing, a Dakshin Bhav. They have Grita Sneha, which is the mode that I am Krishna's. But some gopis, like Srimati Radhika, are Bhamiya Bhav, or left wing, and they have the mode Krishna is mine. Of all the gopis, Srimati Radhika is the topmost. She is a jewel mine of ecstatic love and the source of all conjugal grass. She has unlimited moods, and all the gopis are actually manifestations of their moods, of which 360 are prominent. Go on speaking, go on speaking! Srimati Radhika's love is completely pure and devoid of any tinge of self-interest. Her love manifests as highly advanced and ecstatic moods, such as Adivruta Mahabhav, which decorate and ornament her like captivatingly beautiful and effulgent ornaments. These ecstatic moods include 8 sattvic bhavs, 33 vyabhachari bhavs, and 20 bhava lankars. Upon seeing these bhavs and ecstatic moods on Radhika's body, the waves in the ocean of Krishna's prey increase unlimitedly. For example, there is Tilakinchita Bhav. That is when Srimati Radhika manifests this mood. Krishna cannot resist approaching her, even when she's with all of her friends. She feels jubilant, but at the same time, fearful, angry, jealous, proud, and filled with desire. smiling slightly and at the same time weeping. She tries to cover her face to hide her ecstatic emotions, repelling Krishna's advances and shying away. There are seven other ecstatic emotions which, when combined together on the platform of jubilation, culminate in Mahabhav. Just like a combination of yogurt, ghee, sugar, candy, camphor, cardamom and black pepper, is very sweet and tasty. So the combination of these ingredients of Mahabhav give Krishna the greatest pleasure and satisfy him completely. However, seeing Radharani's ecstasy of Mahabhav, Krishna experiences much more pleasure than he does even by direct union with her.
Oh. Please continue to speak on the ecstatic omens of Srimati Radhika by which she enchants the mind of Govinda.
Being thus requested, Swarup Damodar went on to explain the symptoms of Vilas, Lalita, Kutamita, Vivoka, Motayeta, Mugda, and Chatika. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and all his associates were extremely happy to hear all these explanations.
See the glorious opulence. What could be more opulent than my goddess of fortune? What is there in Vrindavan? There are no golden chariots or palaces in Vrindavan. There are just some wooden carts and forest groves. There are no golden crowns or ornaments. No, just some worthless minerals from the hills. Yeah? Just worthless. Just twigs, leaves, forest flowers, flutes made of dry bamboo, peacock feathers, and gunja berries. There is nothing of any value there. When Lakshmi Devi realized that Jagannath had gone to Vrindavan without her, she was very jealous. Then, after 5 days, when still he had not returned, she became very restless and worried. She was wondering, why has Jagannath left all this opulence to go to Vrindavan? So, in order to make a laughing stock of him, she arranged for so many elaborate arrangements and decorations, and then Lakshmi Devi went with her maidservants to attack the servants of Jagannath. I'm lost for words. They ridiculed her. They ridiculed them, and thus treating them like thieves. They fined them, made them pay fines, and forced them to submit to Lakshmi Devi. And only when they had begged forgiveness at her lotus feet, only then, and when they had promised that the very next day they would bring back Jagannath to her, only then was she pacified. Your gopis are engaged in boiling milk and churning butter. My goddess of fortune sits on a throne of precious gems and jewels. So there is no comparison. My dear Srivas, it seems your mood exactly resembles that of Narad Muni, full of Aishwarya Bhav, the mood of opulence. This must be the direct influence of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Swarup Damodar, is a pure Brijvasi. Therefore, he does not even know what opulence is. He is simply drowning in the ocean of Krishna praying.
My dear Srinivas, have you forgotten the transcendental opulence of Vrindavan? That opulence is like an ocean, whereas the opulence of your Dwarka or Vaikuntha cannot be compared to a single drop. The trees there are desire trees.
The cows are wish-fulfilling cows.
The land itself is made of Chintamani touchstone. And the dust can fulfill all your desires. And therefore Krishna is greedy to taste their pure love and affection, so he will try to steal their hearts by any means. So don't think that Krishna's flute is just a piece of dry bamboo stick. It is his dearmost companion by which he attracts the guard of the gopis and catches their wonderful, precious wealth. So, Vrindavan is full of the highest nectar of Madhurya Ras, which cannot be found in all the three worlds, not in Dwarka and not in Vaikuntha.
High class of Siddhanta that was discussed in the presence of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu between Sarup Damodar and Shivas Pandit. Shivas Pandit is Narad himself, expert in Siddhanta, he is Rasik and Bhav. But Sarup Damodar is really Dalita. No comparison at all. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu only came in this world to test his desires that increased past times he could not. Krishna thinks that I am most beautiful in this world, three worlds. Oh, I am unique, I am parlor. But even when I see Radhika, I'm